Hello and welcome again. You're watching the breaking news show on CNN News 18 and I'm Sakshi Singh Latoria here to walk you through all the top headlines from the nation and across the globe. Straight up talking about Modi 3.0. Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi met President Draupadi Murmu and staked claim to form the NDA government at the centre yesterday. Modi, while addressing the media, said that he is honoured to be chosen by the NDA as the leader and looks forward to forming a stable government at the centre as well. He is all set to now take oath as the Prime Minister for the third historic term tomorrow at 7:15 p.m. And top sources have revealed to CNN News 18 that nearly 12 to 15 spots in the Union Council of Ministers could go to the NDA allies as the BJP top brass begin discussions with their partners. Sources have also said that BJP wants to keep the top ministries, including Home Ministry, External Affairs, Defence as well as Finance with them. TDP and JDU, the two most crucial NDA partners, may also get cabinet berths in this particular government.
साथियों, मेरा बहुत सौभाग्य है कि एनडीए के नेता के रूप में आप सब साथियों ने सर्वसम्मति से चुन करके मुझे एक नया दायित्व दिया है और इसके लिए मैं आपका बहुत बहुत आभारी हूं। आज जब आप मुझे फिर से एक बार ये दायित्व देते हैं, इसका मतलब है कि हम दोनों के बीच हम आपस में विश्वास का सेतु इतना मजबूत है।
Narendra Modi has been elected as the leader of the National Democratic Alliance. The leaders have decided to give Rashtrapati Murmu their letter of support. And now this is how the Rashtrapati Bhavan forecourt is getting ready for that grand oath ceremony on the 9th. Prime Minister Modi will take oath as the Prime Minister of India for the third time. That is where the dais will be. You can see a dais is being set up. That's where Prime Minister and his Union Cabinet will take oath. We don't yet know who will be part of that Union Cabinet. That suspense will remain till the time the oath gets over. Once the oath is over, Rashtrapati Bhavan sends a communique confirming as to who gets what portfolio and what is the shape of the Union Cabinet. So we first saw this in 2014 when Narendra Modi for the first time took oath as Prime Minister of India. At that time also, heads of state from SAARC countries were here at the forecourt. It was a grand affair. This time also, we are told, heads of state from Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, Maldives, Sri Lanka, they are expected to join in here. Also in this forecourt, witnessing Modi 3.0 oath taking ceremony will be the rat miners who helped in the tunnel rescue in Uttarakhand, who will be the workers who helped construct Central Vista, workers who helped construct the new Indian Parliament. So the common man, the Aam Aadmi, also expected to take part in the oath taking ceremony along with top dignitaries. From here, the main area of the forecourt, right down to this point, you can see workers putting up chairs. 7,000 to 8,000 is the number being spoken about. People who will in some form join in for the Prime Minister's oath ceremony. What is the kind of bandobas? Doordarshan cameras are being put up here for the live broadcast. There is a stand that has been set up for Doordarshan broadcast. These pedestal fans have been set up to ensure that the guests are not really uncomfortable while here they are. Now, talking about security, we are told G20-like security will be put in place. In G20, you saw DCP rank officers become commanders, so to say. There were joint forces there from central paramilitary forces, from the intelligence bureau, from the Delhi police, and there was one in charge of officer for each of the venue. That was the protocol in G20. This time around also, a similar protocol could be followed, where multiple agencies will be at work. Considering that heads of states are being invited, it will be a top challenge for the security forces also to ensure that security is maintained. But having said that, the forecourt will be a celebration. I mean, the security will be such that it will not be intrusive. This forecourt of Rashtrapati Bhavan will ensure that for only the second time in India's history where a Prime Minister is taking oath for the third time. It first happened when India's first Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru was sworn in for the third time, and it will happen in 2024 when Narendra Modi is sworn in for the third time.
CNN News 18's Aman Sharma is joining us live on the broadcast. Aman, if you were to talk about the historic third term for Prime Minister-elect Narendra Modi at the moment, what crucial rejigs, so to say, can be expected from the cabinet ministry as far as the word that we have received from our sources are concerned?
See, Sakshi, what we are hearing from our sources is that this will be a council of ministers. Obviously, the BJP is at 240, just a bit short of the majority mark by 32 seats. So it is dependent in a way on the two key ally partners, the TDP as well as the JDU, to ensure a stable, strong government. And this entire exercise, the contours, I would say, of Modi 3.0 Council of Ministers will reflect adequate representation to all regions, all castes, women, OBCs, SCs, STs. And also, we are hearing that 12 to 15 berths in the Union Council of Ministers could go to the allies in the NDA, while the top ministries of the Raisina Hill, Home, Defence, MEA, Finance, are expected to be kept by the BJP. Also, some key ministries close to the Modi 3.0 agenda, like Railways, IT, Education, Law, are expected to remain with the BJP. The TDP and the JDU could get a sizable representation. We are also hearing from the TDP and JDU camps that their priority, and their number one priority, in fact, is adequate financial package for their states. The second priority is the cabinet post. To the TDP with 16 seats, may get one cabinet and two MOS posts. That is what we are hearing. Mr. K. Ram Mohan Naidu, he's a three-time MP from Srikulam of the TDP, a very close confidant of Chandrababu Naidu. He's expected to be the front-runner for the cabinet post from the TDP camp. The JDU with 12 seats would also get one cabinet plus one or two MOS posts. Mr. Lallan Singh, who's a senior leader and aide of Nitish Kumar, as well as Ramnath Thakur, who's the son of Karpuri Thakur and is a JDU leader, are expected to be the front runners for the ministerial post for the JDU. The other key partners, Shiv Sena, Eknath Shinde faction with seven MPs, it is expected a senior Shiv Sena MP, Srirang Barne, could make the cut for the Union Council of Ministers. It could be a cabinet post. The LJP, Chirag Paswan, who scored a 5 out of 5 performance this time, Chirag Paswan could become a Union Cabinet Minister. Also, Jayant Chaudhary from the RLD, who's won two seats this time, Jayant Chaudhary, now Rajya Sabha MP, he could become a Cabinet Minister or a Minister of State with independent charge. The JDS, Mr. H.D. Kumaraswamy, could become a Union Cabinet Minister, is what we are hearing. JDS has won two seats. The NCP of Ajit Pawar has won only one seat, but it has a senior leader in Mr. Praful Patel as the Rajya Sabha MP. So either Mr. Praful Patel or Sunil Tatkare, who's won that seat for the NCP, could be featuring as a Minister of State with independent charge in the new government. We must also remember that Maharashtra elections are going to happen soon, so there will be adequate representation of Maharashtra in the Union Council of Ministers. There's the Janasena, which has won two seats, Pawan Kalyan's party. Senior leader of that party, Mr. Vallabhbhani Balshori, is expected to be one of the persons getting into looking into the Union Council of Ministers. Others are also in the running. We are hearing names of Anupriya Patel, Jitin Ram Manji, Apna Dal and HEM, which have won one seats each. But I would like to stress here that the TDP and the JDU are making it very clear through sources that they are more interested in funds for their states. The financial package for them is their priority. And one-to-one meetings with the JDS, TDP, JDU, NCP, Shiv Sena, LJP, NCP, everything, all these parties have had one-to-one meetings yesterday with the group of senior BJP leaders, Mr. JP Nadda, Mr. Amit Shah, and Mr. Rajnath Singh. The meetings between the top BJP leaders are continuing today as well. And by tomorrow morning, I think we should have a clear idea on who is going to be a part of this Union Council of Ministers.
Sakshi. Definitely. And Aman, that was about the kind of seats that each one of them can actually get. We'll discuss this further, but stay with us. We have got some reactions also coming in this particular story. Let's take a look at that as well.
Now, the challenge is the biggest is Chandra Babu Naidu and Nitish Kumar, who are the अब उनके समर्थन से सरकार बनी है तो संविधान कानून और लोकतंत्र बचाने की जिम्मेदारी ये दो लोगों की है। जिस तरह से शेयर बाजार में उछाल लाया अननेचुरल, ये अपने साथ जो लोग बैठे हैं, चाहे व्यापारी हो चाहे राजनेता हो, उनके उद्योग उनके धंधे को फायदा पहुंचाने के लिए शेयर बाजार का इस्तेमाल किया गया, इसलिए कि गुजरात के दो व्यापारी देश चला रहे हैं और शेयर बाजार से उनका पुराना नाता है, तो ये होता रहेगा।